Welcome to Digital Asset News, to get top stories in cryptocurrency and digital assets and break them down to bite-sized pieces. Today, we've got some information that I think was totally far-fetched and incorrect, but I was wrong again. This is an article that talks about Bitcoin to 500,000. Is it just a matter of time? And again, when I first looked at it, I thought it was crazy, but once you run the numbers, it's legit. And we'll go over everything in detail. Also, DeFi protocol Harvest Finance hacked for 24 million, but there is a bright side. Attacker returns 2.5 million. And the question really gets asked, why do people keep investing in these protocols? And finally, as a PSA, Bitcoin wallet provider Ledger compromised again by malicious phishing attack. And this is going to be what to watch out for suspicious emails. We'll go over all that. But first, let's take a look at what's going on in the market. So today it's October 26th, it's about high noon Texas time. And let's see if we could maintain that momentum that we had for last week. So Bitcoin has done a little bit of a slide down to 12.8. That's down 1% for 24 hours and 12% for the week. But hey, look, just 2 weeks ago, we were hovering around 10,800, 10,700. And here we are at 12.8. Now, yes, we did go up to 13,100, somewhere around there. But you can't keep that momentum forever. There's gonna be people and traders who are going to take profits all the way along this journey. So again, like we talked about yesterday, it's not about just dumping all your money into it because it's gonna go to the moon, everything's gonna be great. You have to understand, it's a seesaw pattern. It's gonna go up, it's gonna go down, and there's a natural trajectory. Just don't FOMO in and dump all your money. I mean, you can FOMO in, that's fine. Just dollar cost average, be an investor, take your time. Success doesn't happen overnight. Also, Ethereum down almost 5% to 388, but again, I'm still pretty happy it's around that 400 mark, and it's still up 2.7 for the week, so hey, everything's good. Tether's Tether, XRP is still pretty stable, around 25 cents, so that's great, I guess. Bitcoin Cash down. You know what really should ask the question is like, what's up? Polkadot's up 4.3, that's great. 450, pretty nice. Litecoin, Bitcoin SV, Cardano, everything's down, of course. Now, it's hard to match momentum from last week when PayPal came out and said, hey, we're gonna offer Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum, and Litecoin on our platform, so everybody line up. That's a pretty good deal. It's hard to really, you know, keep that going, but hey, we're gonna have little slides and that's just normal. Let's see what else we got. 4.5, 5.7, not too great. Everything's pretty much the same, down 5%. Wow, 11% for Uniswap. What the heck happened? If somebody knows why this is going down so much, please let me know. I haven't heard any news about it. No hacks, no problems so far. So that's quite odd. And that's about it. Oh, 8% for Yearn, but that's not surprising, it's Yearn. And that's it. So let's just jump into today's top story because it gets pretty interesting. So first up, Bitcoin to 500K, is it just a matter of time? And I had gone over to Theta and then my live stream, which if you haven't checked it out, it's pretty fun. Come on by. I do it around 11 a.m. Mountain Standard Time, almost every day. And when I first did this article, I was really negative about it because this is the same type of nonsense that people would push out, like that nut John McAfee when he came out and said, hey, Bitcoin to a million. And I remember when he said that because it got me all fired up and excited in 2017. And he said, just math, it's just going to happen and da da da. And then he came out and said, I was just lying. I just want to get people in. I'm like, what a piece of trash. So when I see this type of thing, I'm like, this is so irresponsible to get people's hopes up, you know, about that Bitcoin's going to happen. So when I went to Theta and we talked about it, the first thing I thought to myself was, you know, I should really just run the numbers. And I did, and my whole sentiment changed dramatically, and I'll get to that in a second. But this is where this all comes from. So Tyler and Cameron Winklevoss were on Peter McCormick's podcast, and they just laid it out. They go, look, the question in our mind is not so much, does it go to $500,000 as far as Bitcoin, but how quickly will it get there? His twin, Cameron, added to this that the healthy prediction is actually conservative in that the token will likely be worth more than their bullish estimation. And Cameron states, I would sort of contend that $500,000 Bitcoin is actually pretty conservative and the game hasn't even really started. So again, when I read this and I was on Theta, I'm like, this is so irresponsible to say that because it's not gonna happen. I mean, I said, can you imagine the market cap? And as soon as I said, I go, well, I really don't know that the answer to that question. So I should probably look at the market cap. And thus I did. So this is from Market Cap Calculator. So let's enter the current price of 500,000. The circulating supply, let's say it's 19 million. You know, it's around 18.5 million right now. So let's just put 19 million. And the market cap is 9.5 trillion. And I was like, wait, hold on. That's not too bad, actually. I mean, it sounds like a lot right now, let's be honest. But when I saw this number, I thought to myself, gold. And this is what I'm talking about, because I came over to my favorite visualization of all the money in the world. This was just from May 27, 2020. And if you haven't seen this, you're in for a real treat, because it's kind of mind-blowing. So this square right here is about 100 billion. That's that little square. So silver is sitting around 43 billion, not too bad. Here's crypto. Back in May 27th, it was 244. Now it's around 400 billion, not too bad. But still very minuscule compared to what we're going to look at. Here's military spending. That's a lot. U.S. budget deficit. That's a ton, and it's going up. Coins and banknotes. Fed's balance sheet. Where, newsflash, it's a lot more than that, even though it's at $7 trillion. Here's all the billionaires in the world. Look at these guys. Hey, good for them. And then here's gold. So just look at this. This is gold. This is all of gold. And the world's gold is worth $11 trillion. $11 trillion! I just said Bitcoin at for $500,000 is $9.5 trillion. So let's just say we get some of gold's market cap, because we're going to. And it's not like Peter Schiff is going to have a lot to say about it. He's going to be dealing with his own legal issues. You can look that up. So now let's just go down. Let's just take a look at all the different money markets. So here's the Fortune 500 companies, and Microsoft, Apple, Amazon, Google, and Facebook, they make up about 25% of the S&P 500. Stock markets, $89 trillion. Here's the entire money supply, which I will remind you, 93% is just zeros and ones in a digital ledger in the banks. Only 7% is physical, but it's still almost $100 trillion. $100 trillion. Global debt, $253 trillion. I'm sure it's a lot more. Global real estate, $280 trillion. Just imagine if we can start, when we start tokenizing like skyscrapers and condos and houses and apartment complexes, that's going to be huge for crypto. Here's global wealth, $360 trillion. And then here's the derivatives market we're always talking about. And here's the low side, $558 trillion. And then here's the high side, which we don't really know because there's so much money sloshing around, of $1 quadrillion. I didn't know that word actually existed, quadrillion, until I read this little piece. So when we look at all the different money markets in the world and all the different value, and we think about, wow, $9.5 trillion, that's a lot of money. Well, guess what? It's really not. And when I went over this and I really got into my brain, I'm like, holy shoot, I was totally wrong. So anyhow, this next piece really kind of lays it home. And it's really about how Bitcoin is really going to get to 500K. And this is just one of those many avenues. And the Winklevoss twins, they say, what if every Fortune 100 or 500 company does that? And what he's talking about is just like Michael Saylor, the CEO of MicroStrategy, which we've been talking about ad nauseum on this channel, that how they actually got into Bitcoin. They're saying, what if all the big companies do that? And what if central banks start doing that? It hasn't even started. And they're right. MicroStrategy and Square and Stoneridge and Galaxy Digital, all the companies that are on this listing right here, are the only ones that have put part of their treasury into Bitcoin, and they are up massively. And again, I've been talking about this all the time. When other companies are looking at this and going, wow, guess what our money has done? It has depreciated in value. These guys went into Bitcoin, and look at where they're at. MicroStrategy is up almost 75 million. Galaxy Digital, they've almost doubled. Square has made 11 million in like 2 weeks. So when they look at this, they're like, why aren't we doing this? This is stupid. And then lastly, to really cement the whole argument home as far as, you know, if Bitcoin can actually tear into gold, they put out a nice little piece here which talks about the comparison between Bitcoin and gold, and they make a pretty good point. And there is just one thing that I will say. Gold has been around for thousands of years, and it's going to be around forever. I don't see it really going away, but there is new technology, and there's a new, better way to have a store of value, and I think Bitcoin is it. Now, will it totally replace gold? No, I don't think it'll totally replace gold. I think people will still want to have gold, and I have always said that I think that the new savings account will be gold, silver, Bitcoin. I don't see why people wouldn't have that. So just to look at scarcity, I mean, gold is, it's pretty scarce. But they're still finding mines. There's a new mine that was just found. I posted this on Twitter where they found a new mine in Scotland, and they're preparing to open it up. So as far as like, you know, all these gold bugs are like, well, it's so scarce, it's so scarce. But really, is it? Because they keep finding more of it. So I don't really know how scarce it really is. Now with Bitcoin, it's not scarce. It's finite. It's fixed at 21 million. And really, if we look at the market cap, this whole circulating supply of 19 million, that's not true. That's a lie, because there's a lot of Bitcoin that's been lost. And really, in actuality, we've lost between 2 and 6 million Bitcoin, because people who have mined it in the early days, there it's gone. It cannot come back. It's in some landfill, in some state, in some city that no one will ever be able to touch. So even though we say it's a circulating supply of 19 million, that's a lie. It's actually like around, you know, maybe 17, maybe 15 million. So then it just talks about durability and portability. I think is another big one, because I can send Bitcoin to anyone anywhere in the world in under 30 minutes for next to nothing. If I want to send gold around the world, I mean, forget about it. First, just to get it there. I mean, it's heavy, it's expensive. And then, the fact that I could actually get ripped off. So no, I don't really see that as happening. Divisibility, you can melt down gold, but you know, with Bitcoin, you can have 100 million Satoshis for one Bitcoin. Storage is pretty simple. I mean, I just stored on my Nano Ledger. It's open, it's decentralized. It's never been hacked, so you can't counterfeit it. And then with gold, you can counterfeit gold. I mean, people will figure it out, hopefully, but who knows? And then this is the big one, adoption, which is actually a plus for people who are looking to Bitcoin. Right now, you're really topping out with gold. I mean, more people may get into it. Whatever. But look at the market cap, 200 billion versus 9 trillion. There is huge upside potential, and that is why so many people are getting into it. That's why the institutional investors are getting in, because there is such an asymmetrical investment in this. I've been talking about it so many times. So this is going to be huge. Anyhow, let me know what you think in the comments section. Let's move on. So next up, DeFi protocol. Another one gets hacked. Shocker. What's happening? So decentralized finance, or DeFi protocol, Harvest Finance was hacked on Monday for $24 million. The attacker targeted the protocol's liquidity pools, performing an arbitrage attack using a large flash loan, which is where, you know, it's uncollateralized. They, you know, take a loan out and they put it back before the blocks are actually mined, and then everything's good. And it happened so fast. This hack happened in 7 minutes. So these hackers didn't probably get up off the couch, and in 7 minutes they made $24 million. But there is some good news. They did return $2.5 million. So hey, that's a positive. I'm just kidding. That's ridiculous. So Harvest Finance revealed that the hacker manipulated prices on One Money Lego, or Curve Y Pool, to drain another Money Lego, which is Farm, or Farm USDC, many times over. They kept doing it again and again and again. The attacker then converted the funds to REN BTC and then exited to Bitcoin. So yeah, pretty easy day for to make $24 million. The three-month-old platform said that there is a significant amount of personally identifiable information on the attacker. And this is where it gets good, in my opinion. And they state this is the attacker is well known in the crypto community. They weren't willing to dox or, you know, let out who it was as far as a cyber thief. But Harvest Finance is now offering a $100,000 bounty for the person or team to reach out to the attacker. Now, this is where it gets interesting to me, because I'm like, are you talking about 100,000, like send them a message like, hey, we know who you are, return it or else report the authorities, or like reach out with, a bat and break his kneecaps, you know, what are they talking about? Like, you're talking about like some kind of like gangster stuff, like, hey, why don't you return the money? You owe us $24 million. You've disrespected us. I mean, is it that, or is it like, hey, we know who you are? Either way, 100,000 is 100,000. I'm just saying. And then finally, Harvest's hack comes just 6 weeks after an attacker made off with $8 million in Bitcoin from their DeFi protocol, BZX. However, BZX managed to recover the funds. But the big thing is that this keeps happening again and again and again. So I don't understand why people get into DeFi. I know it's a lot of money, but it's another shiny object. And you just have to, you know, if you're looking for quick money, there's ways to do that. It's super risky. I wouldn't recommend it. But my whole thing is just be an investor. Dollar cost average, be a little bit safe. It may take you a little bit longer, but it's a safer path, and you're not on this road to destruction. So are people going to make a lot of money in DeFi? Absolutely. Are a lot more people going to get wrecked? Obviously. Before we move on, I want to give a shout out to a guy from Coin Bureau, because he actually tweeted this out on October 25th. And he states, why are people throwing $1 billion into a DeFi protocol with an anonymous developer and a single admin key? He wrote this on October 25th. So he's pretty much warning people, don't do this. This is ridiculous. And then, of course, today he just puts it out like, hey, this is what happens when you invest into something that crappy. And I got to tell you, hats off to Guy for just, you know, laying it out there. And I said, Guy, you're a gem in the space. Keep fighting the good fight and saving people from themselves. So that's all I want to say. Anyhow, let me know what you think in the comments section. Let's move on. Next up, Bitcoin wallet provider Ledger compromised again by malicious phishing attack. So what is going on? This is just a cautionary tale, just like a PSA for everybody, just so they are aware. This is what's happening. Some Ledger hardware wallet users received phishing emails with software that led to a loss of funds. The hack may have resulted from the company's user data breach in July of 2020. Don't remember? There was a data breach where some emails and personal information was leached off of their website. And this is why probably some hackers got some emails of people who own a Ledger, sent them an email and said, hey, you need to update your information. We need your passphrases, mnemonic phrases, whatever you want to call them. And they are just sending this out like, hey, we will never ask you for your passphrase. So don't give it out to anybody because they're just going to steal all your funds. And then pretty much they say it right here. Scam alert. According to information, some scammers are getting in touch with Ledger users through text message and emails. Never give your 24 words of your recovery seed. Ledger will never ask for them. And just to sum it all up, and it's a pretty good statement. I got to start using this more. It says, a valuable lesson hardware wallet users can take away is remembering the famous crypto adage, don't trust, verify. And the last thing I'll say is this. So the Nano Ledger, this is a phishing attack, but the Nano Ledger is still a secure hardware wallet. I still trust it. And like we talked about yesterday, this is where I have my entire portfolio allocated. So 60% is in the Ledger, 30% is on Celsius. I got 9% roughly on exchanges Coinbase and Kraken, so I can institute my bull run strategy, and then 1% on Brave. So I still trust it. I still believe it. And I still think everyone should have a hardware wallet because not your keys, not your crypto. And also, if you have need of a hardware wallet or a Ledger, they're giving 20% off this week. All you have to use, the link in the description below looks just like this. And at checkout, just type in digital asset news and you will get 20% off. So that is it for today. So look, I want to say thanks for sticking with me through the entire video. I know it was a lot of information, but a lot of good stuff out there, especially that 500,000. I was totally wrong about that. But again, thanks for sticking with me. Appreciate it. If you like those types of videos, there's going to be two more that's going to pop up on your left and right. I'll let YouTube decide all that. And that's it for today. So thanks again. Appreciate it. See you on the next one.